let it slide. Let your troubles fall behind you. Let it shine till you feel it all around you. And I don't mind if it's me you need to turn to. We'll get by. It's the heart that really matters.
Through God forbid, fate should step in and force us into a goodbye. If you have children someday, when they point to the pictures, I had the time of my life.
side, Jimmy, go left. Right. Obviously, no technical difficulties in transitioning from outside to inside. It's as smooth as it gets. We forgot our left and our right, but I swear we're ready for high school. We're gonna need just 2 minutes to get this figured out, and then we'll get us started, guys. Hang with us, please. Come on. We'll figure it out in a second.
Thank you.
can't clean it. That's fine. Keep it there for now. Students, will you please take your seats? We worked on that part, right? Good evening, everyone. My name is Bob Schertz, and I am the very proud assistant principal of Bordentown Regional Middle School. Welcome to our 2023 promotion ceremony. We are very pleased you could join us this, well, not so gorgeous afternoon, but we're going to make the most of it, to celebrate the promotion of our eighth grade class. At this time, I would like to invite the select chorus and our student speakers to come forward. Will everyone please stand while the choir sings the Star Spangled Banner? Thank you for the beautiful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner. Students, may you please sit down. At this time, please join me in welcoming our Student Council President, Miriam McHale, as she stares her student greeting.
Good evening, eighth grade graduates, teachers, administrators, parents, and families. My name is Miriam McHale, and I had the privilege of being our school's student council president. Spread kindness like confetti. It is hard not to think of Bordentown Regional Middle School when you hear these four words that marked our middle school journey. Words that we will carry along with us. Words that were visible on our walls, words that were heard in our halls, and most importantly, words that were felt in our hearts. Kindness. It's a word that we felt every day through the compassion of our teachers and staff. Teachers and staff, we know you truly care. We see the effort you put in, and we are thankful for the lessons you have taught us and tools you have given us. Graduates, keep in mind that our parents and teachers are not the only ones responsible for our success. We need to be our own inspiration. So find something to be grateful for each day, be kind to others, support each other, and encourage everyone you meet to be a good person. We first need to be able to inspire ourselves before we can influence our peers. So let's continue to be inspirational for ourselves and future generations to come. We are only as successful as our leaders teach us to be. Thank you, Mr. Schertz, for being there for all of us and never leaving one of us behind, especially those of us who show up a little too late to school in the morning. Definitely not me. And today, on behalf of the entire 8th grade class, thank you, Mr. Sprague. Your leadership and values makes a difference in our school each and every day. You lead your teachers to be great teachers, and you lead your students to be great people. In the end, you are sending off 207 graduates who will always put the shopping cart away. And of course, we cannot forget our parents and guardians. Thank you for sacrificing so much for us, from making sure we brush our teeth to getting our homework done on time. You have shaped us into the people we are today. Inclusiveness. Being unique and different is a beautiful trait. In our small world today, we still struggle with the acceptance of differences. But make no mistake, the strongest communities are the ones that embrace the differences, uniqueness, and individuality of its members. It is our responsibility that wherever our paths take us, we continue to build a strong, inclusive community that embraces diversity and authenticity. Be different, be yourself, accept others for being different, and accept others for being themselves. Together we are stronger, and together we can make a difference for the better. Last but not least, my closing message is directed towards my fellow 8th grade graduates. I feel your enthusiasm, we're all looking good. And today we're celebrating a milestone, a sense of completion, and a sense of moving on into a new start. Regardless of where your path takes you, work hard, have fun, and don't forget to spread kindness like confetti. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Miriam. You have stood as a wonderful representation for our student body over the last several years, and we appreciate everything you have done while here at BRMS. Even your willingness to help out and get here on time. Once again, good afternoon, BRMS families and distinguished guests. It is my pleasure to welcome you to our Bordentown Regional Middle School 2023 promotion ceremony. We appreciate you joining us here today and want to thank each of you for the individual roles you have played for these students being honored tonight, as well as for your collective efforts to support our school community over the past 3 years. At this time, I would like to acknowledge and extend our sincere thanks and appreciation to several people for attending this evening and for their continued support of our middle school. First, Dr. Trudy Atkins, our superintendent of schools. Mr. Michael James, Board of Education president. Mr. Joseph Dean, he is now the Board of Ed vice president. Mr. Michael Melvin, assistant principal at Bordentown Regional High School. To all of our distinguished guests, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and students of the middle school, please accept our sincere thanks and appreciation for your support of our school and your willingness to share this special evening with us. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you again, Mr. Joseph Dean, Board of Ed vice president, for a congratulatory message.
Bear with me, guys. I got one of my babies up there, so I told her I wasn't going to pick on her too much, but I got my dad girl socks on. So, good evening, graduates of 2023, families, distinguished guests, school administrators, Dr. Atkins, members of the Board of Education. I am honored to stand here before you today as we celebrate incredible achievements of the 8th grade class. Today marks an exciting and powerful moment in your lives. You are stepping toward a new phase of existence that is loaded with possibilities and potential. The decisions you make now from now on will have a profound impact on your future. Will you choose the path of least resistance, or will you set ablaze your own trail, daring to create a life of authentic and meaningful life? Becoming the best self requires more than simply setting goals and working hard. It requires deep understanding of who you are and what you value and what you desire from life. The understanding, not something that can just be given in a book or imparted by a teacher, no. It's something that must be discovered through experience, introspection, and self-reflection. Over the next 4 years, you will face countless challenges and obstacles. You will question your abilities, your choices, and your worth. You will be tempted to take the easy road, to follow the crowd and settle for mediocrity. But I challenge you to rise above those temptations, to reject the complacency and conformity, and to pursue your wildest dreams with all your passion and determination. You see, as you all embark on this new phase of your lives, you have a unique opportunity to map out your future with your whole heart and all your dreams. The next 4 years will be a time for endless opportunities for growth and self-discovery. Some of you may not even know what you want to do yet with your lives, and that's okay. This is the time to explore different interests, to discover your true passions. It's time to take risks and try new things, but whatever path you choose, please remember that success is not measured solely by financial or material achievements. True success comes from finding what makes you happy and fulfilled, pursuing that with all your might. As you leave middle school behind and prepare for high school, it's important to reflect on the challenges and inspiring moments that have shaped you over the past few years. Here's just three examples. The pandemic taught resilience and perseverance. Personal achievements, whether it be a school project, sports team championship, or a personal goal that you set for yourself, that taught you hard work and determination. And building new friendships. Many have different perspectives, and these friendships taught you the value of connection and community. Now that we have reflected on the past, let's look for the future. Here are a couple three. I think I got an extra credit for you too. So embrace change, embrace the challenge. Don't be afraid to step out of your box and out of your comfort zone. This will help you grow and become a better version of yourself. Surround yourself with positive influences. The friends you hang around with the most have the biggest impact on your life and who you become. Seek friends who inspire and encourage you to be the best self. Number three, pursue passions. High school is a time to explore your interests, discover who you are and what you're passionate about. Whether it's playing an instrument, joining a club, or trying to try out for sports, follow your heart and do what brings you joy. And this is for the extra credit. Pay it forward. As you grow and evolve in high school, remember to help others along the way, whether it be sharing your knowledge and skills, volunteering in community, or lending support to those in need. But be a positive influence and leave your mark on the world. Lastly, I leave you with the ultimate cheat codes. So parents, you can thank me later. This is a poem by Shel Silverstein. Listen to the mustn'ts, child. Listen to the don'ts. Listen to the shouldn'ts, the impossibilities, the won'ts. Listen to the never haves. Listen to me close. Anything can happen, child. Anything can be. Congratulations, 2023.
Thank you very much, Mr. Dean. At this time, we would like to present to you the first of our three student special addresses, and our welcome address will be given by Lainey Rozelle.
Good afternoon, Board of Education, Administration, staff, graduates, and families. I'm Lainey Rozelle, and I would like to welcome you to the 8th grade promotion ceremony. I am honored to be here today to celebrate this special occasion with all of you. This is a day that will be remembered for years to come, and I'm so glad that we get to share it together. First and foremost, I want to congratulate the graduates. We have worked hard to get to this point, and we should be proud of everything we have accomplished. This is a major milestone in our lives, and it's only the beginning of all the great things we will achieve in the future. I also want to welcome the families, teachers, and staff who have supported us graduates throughout our journey. Your love, guidance, and encouragement have helped us become the amazing young people we are today. Graduates, let's show our appreciation for all our biggest supporters with a round of applause. As we gather here today, I can't help but reflect on all the memories we've shared together over the years. From the first day of middle school being online, to later that year entering the school wearing masks, to this last night together as middle schoolers. We've laughed together, we've learned together, and we've grown together. We've had our ups and downs, but we always stuck together as a community. That's what makes this moment so special. So as we soon say goodbye to middle school and hello to high school, it's important to remember the lessons we've learned. We've learned that hard work pays off, that kindness goes a long way, and that we can achieve anything we set our minds to. We've learned to be resilient in the face of adversity, to never give up on ourselves, and to always keep pushing forward. In closing, I want to say how proud I am of each and every one of us. We are all amazing young people with bright futures lying ahead. We have the power to make the changes we want to see in the world, and I can't wait to continue to grow and learn with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lainey. Our second address, the thank you address, will be given by Kaylee Jeffrey.
Good evening, Board of Education members, administration, staff, graduates, and families. On behalf of the entire 8th grade class, thank you all for being here. I think I speak for all of us when I say thank you. Thank you to the red track, which helped us exercise after lunch. We forgive you for staining everyone's shoes. Thank you to the big red lockers that guarded our belongings. We forgive you for getting stuck when we need you the most. Thank you to the bell for not ringing until 7:58. Waking up earlier and being at school by 7:20 next year is going to be a challenge. Thank you, cafeteria, for giving us a place to eat lunch. We forgive you for being way too early in the day because you provided us with a place to talk with friends. Thank you to the halls that guided us to our destinations. We forgive you for being too crowded, as you were filled with art, the sounds of laughter, and love. Thank you to the clubs and sports teams we dedicated our time to, and where we made friends that became our family. Thank you to the fields outside for building exceptional teams and families. Thank you to the gym for creating champions. Thank you to the classrooms that helped students thrive and discover their inner geniuses. Thank you to the stage for helping students find their musical creativity. Thank you to the middle school traditions over the past 3 years, like field trips to amusement parks, camps, and more, that have left an imprint on our lives. We forgive you, COVID, for stealing any experiences we may have missed. Thank you to our family members who have supplied us with advice. Thank you to teachers who have stretched out a hand and guided us throughout our years and helped us find our passion. Thank you to our friends who we made wonderful memories with. Thank you to our principals, Mr. Schertz and Mr. Sprague, aka DJ Jazzy Sprague, who have made our safety and happiness their top priority. Thank you to every coach, club advisor, and teacher who has helped us grow up. Thank you, Bordentown Regional Middle School, for helping us to become the people we are today, so we can say hello to high school, hello to new people, hello to a new path filled with many amazing adventures, hello to new experiences and creating new memories. And lastly, hello to new opportunities that will guide our future. We're so lucky to have so much to be thankful for. Thank you.
Great job. Thank you, Ms. Kaylee. And next, Leah Isley, will you please come to the podium for our farewell address?
It has been a pleasure being with everyone this evening. Eighth graders, we have officially made it through our last year at BRMS. For most of us, it has been 3 years here. Yet, it feels like just yesterday we were entering the doors for the first time as scared seventh graders, not knowing where our class was or how to find the bathroom. But in these 3 years, we have learned that middle school isn't as scary as we thought it would be. There are teachers who care for us, friends who encourage us, and a place for all of us to express ourselves. And throughout middle school, whether you joined a club, tried out for a sport, or got a good grade on a test, every single student here has something to be proud of. If middle school seems scary, high school probably feels terrifying for a lot of us. But in high school, there are so many more opportunities where we could strive to succeed. I hope that every student here achieves great things and tackles any obstacles in their way to go even further beyond what they have accomplished here at BRMS. With a good mindset and what you have learned in middle school, you can reach the goals and desires you have been aspiring to. Don't ever turn away or stop trying. As Elle Woods from the movie Legally Blonde once said, you must always have faith in people. And most importantly, you must always have faith in yourself. With this being said, when it comes to things you want in life, you must work for it, not just wish for it. As we travel on to the next leg of our journey, I would like to offer 3 pieces of advice. Firstly, you will fail, miss a shot, make many mistakes. Learn from them, use them to improve, strive to do better. Next, as a student, you have the ability to make an impact in your school and make a difference. Never forget about your voice and let it be heard. Lastly, don't be so nervous figuring out the future. Don't get me wrong, thinking about the future is imperative for our success. But enjoy these next few years while they last. Before you know it, we will be turning our high school graduation tassels from right to left and walking this same stage once again. A little older, a little more mature, but probably still nervous about what our future will hold. So, no matter which high school you plan to attend, go to football games, join clubs, make new friends, try out for a new sport, go crazy for homecoming week, and have the best high school experience for you. For some of us, this is farewell for a while. For others, only until September. So farewell, future freshmen. I am so excited to see what we accomplish in our next chapter. Thank you. We did it.
Thank you, Leah. And once again, to each of our 4 students selected to speak tonight, great work. And thank you for your magnificent speeches. Most appreciated. And now, Mr. Michael Melvin and Student Council Representative A.J. Danthula, would you please come up and join me at the podium? Mr. Melvin is the assistant principal here at the high school, and A.J. is the Bordentown Regional High School Student Council President. Correct, sir? Congratulations. And both are here to accept our BRMS class of 2023 to be our HS. Mr. Melvin?
Good evening, everybody. Dr. Atkins, Mr. Sprague, Mr. Schertz, distinguished Board of Education members, community leaders, teachers, family members, and friends. On behalf of the administration, faculty, and staff of Bordentown Regional High School, I would like to congratulate the BRMS class of 2023 on their 8th grade promotion. This is a momentous occasion where we get to celebrate your achievements, perseverance, and successes throughout your years at BRMS. Thanks to your teachers and families, we hope you find yourself prepared and excited for the journey ahead. As your freshman assistant principal, I look forward to getting to know you and assisting you in any and all ways possible. If you're going to be successful at BRHS, here are a few pointers to keep in mind. Always believe in yourself and your dreams. Know that you are destined for great things as long as you work hard, get involved, stay focused, and keep a positive attitude and mindset. Don't be afraid to ask for help from your teachers, guidance counselors, or administrators. Try new things and broaden your horizons. And always surround yourself with people who are going to uplift you and have your best interests at heart. Our staff cannot wait to meet you and to help you achieve all of your dreams. And so once again, I congratulate our families and our students. And now let me be the first to say, welcome to our Scotty family, our new class of 2027. Congratulations. And now I would like to offer our BRHS Student Council representative, AJ Donthula, for a chance to say a few words.
All right, if anyone's wondering why I have sunglasses, we were outside for graduation yesterday. I thought we were going to be outside today too, but on the bright side, you guys get to see my beautiful eyes, so that's good. All right, good evening, parents, administration, faculty, and of course, the soon-to-be graduates of Bordentown Regional Middle School. Today, I stand before you as Ajay Donthula, your 2023-2024 Student Council President. First and foremost, let's thank the parents for raising these graduates. Your hard work, rigor, and dedication to your children will not be forgotten. Now on, there you go. Now on to the main event. Congratulations to the class of 2023 for completing middle school. It was, there you go. It was no small feat, and each one of you should be proud of your accomplishments. But the funny part is, your journey has just begun. As you embark on your high school journey, I want to share some valuable advice with you. High school is a time of growth, discovery, and endless possibility. The key to making most of these 4 years is simple: get involved. Whether it's sports, theater, band, choir, or clubs, there's something for everyone. This is your chance to explore your passions, try new things, and forge lifelong friendships. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about what happens in high school. Let's start with homecoming. Picture this: hallways filled with breathtaking decorations, dress-up days filled with creativity, lunchtime games that will have you laughing until your sides hurt, the thrill of the money race between classes, and of course, the homecoming football game, where our collective spirits reaches its peak. Trust me when I say, the more you immerse yourself in these activities, the more memorable it becomes. Our theme for this year is actually Dr. Seuss, and your grade is in it to win it. It's not gonna be easy, but you can try. But that's not all. Our school calendar is packed with a variety of thrilling events, from the exhilarating volleyball tournament to the epic Powder Puff football game and the legendary Wing Bowl. There's never a dull moment. These experiences will shape your high school years and create memories that will last a lifetime. You see, high school isn't about getting good grades. I mean, for the parents, it kind of is, but it's about finding things you love, finding a balance between work and fun, and finding friends who support and inspire you. So as you get ready to start high school, remember to explore different activities, try new things, and find your own special place where you feel connected and valued. These experiences will shape who you are and make your time in high school truly memorable. Now, let me be the second one to say it. Welcome, Scotties, to the BRHS family.
Thank you, Mr. Melvin and Ajay. For the musical address tonight, our middle school ensemble will perform a piece entitled My Country, Tis of Thee. Mrs. Stallworth Glitz and the BRMS Ensemble, thank you. Excellent work. And now, our BRMS Select Choir. If you'd come up, please. The BRMS Select Choir will be singing United.
Sure.
Thank you, Mrs. Cafaro, and our BRMS Select Chorus. That sounded beautifully. At this time, we'd like to transition to an awards portion of the promotion ceremony and actually start by taking a second to acknowledge our daytime eighth grade award winners. Please stand as we announce you. Our Scholar Athlete Award winners, Madison Medea and Joseph Hartz. Our Special Commendation, Leah Isley. Our Marion E. Lynch Humanitarian Award, Analia Sukashana and Patrick Mazek. The Rotary Club of Bordentown, Angela DiIzzo, Aiden Rich, Charlotte Jones, and Adam Palmer. And our Ellen Rosenberg Social Studies Award went to Alex DiBenedetto and Ava Brennan. At this time, Mrs. Christina Watson and Mrs. Lisa Bartolome, could you please join me up here at the podium? This school year, Mrs. Watson, a science teacher, was selected as the Bordentown Regional Middle School 2022-2023 Educator of the Year. And Mrs. Lisa Bartolome, an instructional aide, was selected as the 22-23 Educational Services Professional of the Year. These recognitions are more than deserved for each of these staff members, and we are still appreciative of their efforts and the efforts that both of you make for our students each and every day. Thank you so very much. Mrs. Watson and Mrs. Bartolome will be assisting me in presenting several achievement awards this evening. We are fortunate to have special groups and individual honors for our student achievements. The first award being presented is the Rotary Club of Bordentown Award, presented to our eighth grade students who have excelled during the school year by giving service to our community. This year, the award winners are Rebecca Candia. Come on up, Rebecca. Cade Sutton. Kara Gallagher. And Lucas Schwartz. Congrats to all. Next, the Carl Berkheimer Memorial Award, presented to an eighth grade student who exhibits good citizenship, school spirit, and satisfactory effort in all areas. This year's award winner, Andrew Barrett. Next, our Bordentown Regional PTO Award, presented to the students of the eighth grade class who have shown the most improvement, both personally and academically, during the past 3 years. Our two winners are Nicholas Soltes and Gabrielle Dean. The Elizabeth Vanekoven Tenacity Award is given to two students that have been tenacious in their academic and social pursuit during their time at BRMS. This year's award winners, Idris Opong. And Ryan Frick. The Nelson T. Sievers Memorial Trust Service Award is presented to an eighth grade student who has displayed good citizenship, service, and kindness to others. This is presented to Adam Palmer. The American Legion Urban Post No. 26 Award presented to the girl of the eighth grade class who has excelled in qualities of leadership and service. This award goes to Lainey Roselle. And the American Legion Irvin B. Post No. 26 Award presented to the boy of the eighth grade class who has excelled in qualities of honor, courage, scholarship, leadership, and service is presented to Augustus Myers. The Mary Jo Young Memorial Award presented to the eighth graders who best exemplify the qualities that Ms. Young, through her exceptional teaching, shared with Bordentown Regional Middle School students every day. Courage, concern for others, and a love of life. This award has been made possible by a grant in her memory. Our winners this year, Kaylee Jeffrey. Gabrielle Stout.
Right behind you, Mr. Sprite.
And Chase Martin. The Leon M. Seidel Memorial Trust Fund Award, given in memory of Dora Sangren, to the female student obtaining the highest average on graduation from eighth grade at Bordentown Regional Middle School. This award is to be used at the sole discretion of the recipient. This year's award is presented to Sahasra Corby. The Leon M. Seidel Memorial Trust Fund Award, given in memory of Dora Sangren, to the male student obtaining the highest average on graduation from eighth grade at Bordentown Regional Middle School. This award is to be used at the sole discretion of this recipient. And the award is presented to Rohan Patel. At this time, I would like to bring up our Bordentown Regional Middle School principal, Mr. Joseph Sprague.
Thank you. Before I get started with my prepared speech, I just want to take this second to thank some people who made tonight possible. We made this the transition inside, and there was a lot of moving parts. So I just want to take a second to thank Stacy Morano, who's in the charge of the pack back there. So thank you, Ms. Morano. I also want to thank our IT department. Drew Potter's back there, so he set everything up for us so we could be live on YouTube. And I also want to thank our director, our new director of Buildings and Grounds, Ms. Lisa Gonzalez. I don't know if she's around here, but got all the, everything moved inside. So thank you. All right, here we go. As we sit here tonight recognizing our phenomenal eighth grade class of 2023, I would be remiss if I did not thank some other people who helped guide them along the way. First, I would like to thank our teachers and staff for all that they have done to help all of our students develop and grow over these last 3 years. When Mr. Schertz and I are interviewing candidates for teaching positions, we will always make sure to ask this one simple question. Why do you want to teach middle school? That was supposed to be a joke, but it didn't go well. Teaching middle school is definitely not for everyone, and I'm very fortunate to have the staff that I do that is so dedicated and genuinely cares about their students. So students, I'd appreciate if you just gave your teachers one big round of applause. All right, there's another joke coming, so hopefully this one goes over a little bit better. All right, here we go, ready? Next, I would like to thank all the families and parents of our students who are being promoted tonight. My son just had his eighth grade graduation last week, so I'm well aware of all the fun times that go along with being the parent of a 13 or 14-year-old. All right, it's getting better, I promise. All right. Whether it's the constant reminders to put their clothes away or the dishes that they think will magically move themselves to the sink, being the parent of a middle school student is definitely a unique time, but one that is filled with a lot of fond memories. Parents, without your love, support, and patience, our students will not be where they are today. So students, I would appreciate it if you gave your parents a nice big round of applause. I'm gonna tell a brief story that embodies the message that we try to deliver at Bordentown Regional Middle School, and hopefully is a mindset that these graduates carry with them as they move forward. Last week at our Watch Awards, Mr. Rivera stole my thunder a little bit by briefly talking about the story. So I apologize if you've heard it before, but the message is something I think is pretty important for our kids to hear again. This is the story of the coffee bean. Abe is a high school student who was weighed down by worries about football, criticisms, negativity, and his parents' relationship issues. His science teacher, Mr. Jackson, helps him to shift his perspective through a metaphor on life. Mr. Jackson explains to Abe that life is often like a pot of very hot water. It can be harsh, stressful, and a difficult place. Excuse me. He tells Abe that he will find himself in environments and facing conditions that test who he really is and can change, weaken, or harden him if he lets them. Mr. Jackson asks him to consider what happens to a carrot, an egg, and a coffee bean when they are boiled. He asks Abe to try this at home that night. The next day, Abe comes to school and he sees Mr. Jackson and he tells him what happened. He reports that the carrot got soft and weakened and that the egg became hardened. But the coffee bean transformed its environment, and the boiling water became coffee. Mr. Jackson tells him, no matter how hard things get or how hopeless things look, don't give up. Realize that we don't create our world from the outside in, we create it and transform it from the inside out. If you think you are a carrot and you will believe the power and forces outside of you are more powerful than who you are on the inside, and you will become weaker. If you think you are an egg, you will believe the negativity in the world has the power to harden your heart and cause you to become negative like the world. But if you know you are a coffee bean, you won't allow the outside world to impact you. You will know the power inside of you is greater than the forces outside of you. And with this insight, you will transform your environment and the world around you from the inside out. Members of the Bordentown Regional Middle School Class of 2023, as you move forward in this new and amazing journey, it is always important that you focus on your effort and give everything you have to all that you do. You control how hard you work, not your teachers, not your parents, you. It is very powerful to be in control of something. Please never forget that. Throughout the year, we have spoken often about being the person who puts the shopping cart away, the person who does the right thing when no one is watching. That is the definition of your character. And again, you are in complete control of that. It is very rare in life that we get a fresh start. And in September, you're going to have that opportunity at a fresh start. If you focus on your effort and your character, two things that you are in complete control of, I know that you will make us proud. To conclude, I encourage you to always be a coffee bean and be the best version of yourself that you can be. Thank you for being you and making an impact at BRMS. At this time, on behalf of the BRMS faculty and staff, I would like to congratulate you on your promotion to high school. Thank you.
Dr. Atkins, Mr. Sprague, Mrs. Watson, and Mrs. Bartolome. Are we ready for the presentation of the class? Excellent. At this time, I'd like to also call up Ms. Patterson, if you could come on up. Ms. Patterson, the microphone is all yours.
Good evening. It is with great pleasure that I present to you the Bordentown Regional Middle School Class of 2023. Isaac Derek Alvarado. Alexa Sharina Amarante. Ann Amarante. Anish Amin. Alexander James Augustine. Abel Emery Azinger. Andrew P. Barrett. Christopher Michael Basile. David Daniel Baxter. Samantha May Beagle. Tyler Christopher Bell. Amelia Bellamy. Jared Deneen Benton. Madison Gail Berardi. Michelle Risa Birchie. Daniela Eileen Bachinke. Avery Christine Boyer. Connor Jace Bramley. Ava Michelle Brennan. Ellie Mayee Briggs. John Richard Brovac.
Cassandra Joan Bryan. Tyler Russell Bryan. William Buddenbaum. Michael Anthony Calderon. Sebastian Edward Caldwell. Rebecca Amelia Cundia. Marco Frederick Carlini. Kara Drew Chen Chang. Tio Chow. Mia Lynn Cortez. Nicholas Ryan Cox. Anthony Abel Chrysostomo. Alyssa Lynn Cruzen. Angela Patricia DeIso. Daniel Vincent DeIso. Gabrielle Rosa Dean. Tugra Demir. Kendra Joy DePew. Alexander Scott DiBenedetto. Gabriella Yasunya Egan. Leah J. Isley. Derek James Enslin. Katie Isabella Erickson. Austin Kelly Faison West. Brody Christopher Farfalla. Alexa Feminella. Jillian Marie Fenton. Spencer Russell Fenton. Richard Allen Fisher. Jaden Lewis Florence. David James Forker. Edgar Franco. Ryan Joseph Frick. Christopher B. Fuentes Estrada. Kara Elizabeth Gallagher. Brianna Kathleen Gallo. Peter Joseph Gambino. Adriel Garcia. Ethan Patrick Jens. Riley Ann Jens. Harmon Singh Gill. Jumari Aaron Glover. Ethan Matthew Gold.
Matthew Thomas Hage.
Jared Blake Hall. Hunter Patrick Hampson. Joseph Spencer Hartz. Zoe Marie Hay. Jean Mordecai Henry. Zachary Ryan Hickman. Hayden James Hitt. Joseph Hawk. Everett Reese Hazu Barrett. Madeline Grace Husanai. Orion Lorto Innocent. Sebastian Innocent. Kamaya Jackson. Gabriel James Jarvie. Kaylee Cynthia Jeffrey. Cooper Gerard Gary Johnson. Robert Carter Johnson. Charlotte Jane Jones. Connor William Jones. Gianni Amir Jones. Ayana Anna Jones. Madeline May Jones. Maya Elizabeth Julius. Olivia Ann Keefe. Sean Michael Kelly. Jakai Johnny Kernanzen. Sabrina Killick. Sophie Elizabeth Kim. Lucas Raymond Klama. Sahasara Corvi. Alexa Elizabeth Kraus. Dean Michael Krinsicki. Nathan Joseph Crinsley. Baswa Aboji Kumi. Talon Alexander Lau. Brighton Chandler Luddix. Thomas Marvin Lee. Brandon Thomas Lewandowski. Aiden Hunter Lobo. Aubrey Olivia Lauer. Madison Lee Medea. Christopher Lee Malcolm. Alexa Maldonado. Darius James Mann. Emmanuel Manning. Ariana Elizabeth Margarine. Chase Christopher Martin. Nathan Lewis Martin. Alexander Gerardo Martucci. Lawrence Japloff Massapply. Vincenzo Marco Mastriani. Patrick Evan Maziak. Bradley Andrew Matthews. Anna Michelle McInmoyle. Charlotte Rose McGlenn. Miria Naomi McHale. Sydney Jade Metzler. Carmela Rose Mickus. Isabella Lauren Mitchell. Ariana Mong. Sienna Novell Montrevino Molvin. Dylan Michael Murphy. Augustus Robert Myers. Joseph Thomas Nisaka. Dean Henry Nicolini. William John O'Brien. Shabrizi Christian Abuku. Adris Opong Chaitchaku.
Juliana Marie Pato. Paula Camila Palacios. Vanessa Belin Palacios. Adriana Lynn Palermo. Adam Joseph Palmer. Rohan Patel. Haley Rose Pollock. Grayson James Pelican. Aiden Michael Peters. Pierce Mikkel Peters. Jacinda Denise Postel. Bhargav Prasanna. Siana Emilce Ramirez. Jackson Cole Rayner. Eva Marie Reeves. Ivan Preston Reyes. Lulu Madison Reyes. Aiden Raymond Rich. Jacob Theodore Richardson. Candice Marie Roga. Robert Rosario. Cole Rosina. Lainey Renee Russell. Adriana Rucall. Megan Ruiz. Brett Charles Rupert. Raneem Salama. Shiloh Joel Samuel. Jose Juan Santiago. Gianna Marie Sciano. Lucas Allen Schwartz. Alistair Sexton. Benjamin George Sexton. Peter Francis Silipino. Nicholas Soltes. Idris Andrin Spriggs. Gregory Philip Stalnicker. Wyatt Christian Steckley. Gabriella Kathleen Stout. Carter Dean Stumpf. Analia Suka Shanai. Peter Ruben Sokola. Cade Robert Sutton. Tawisha Talgary. Mark Daniel Castillo Terriella. Avery Corinne Taylor. Kenneth Teague. Peyton Elizabeth Tadero. Cassidy Toth. Jordan Manibo Trinidad. Trayvon Turner. David Stephen Taluki. Sanaya Valakta. Rocky Alberto Valentin. Joelle Nicole Vescovi. Jacob Benjamin Warren. Evan Christopher Wortman. Jamie Grace Yoder. Caitlin Grace Young. Joshua Youssef. Emily Anya Udalevich. Darlin Uganaula. Jack Robert Zaremba. Kaylee Jane Zadrowski. Christopher Edward Ziegler. Lila Suzanne Ziegler. And Aiden Wayne Zuzulak.
We're going to try to do a little better on the way out. We're going to see how it goes, though. Just a reminder or a heads up for some, after we recess, we are actually going to meet everyone down in the gymnasium. We will not be meeting here in the auditorium. We'll recess out down the hallway into the gymnasium, and you can meet all your students down there. And at this time, class of 2023, please stand. Yeah, we're going to try. You're going to take, Will, no, you want to take that way? Take Isaac out? Well, for the very last time, I just want to acknowledge and congratulate each of you as eighth graders on your many middle school achievements, because it is with great pleasure that I present to everyone here tonight the Bordentown Regional High School Class of 2027. Thank you all for sharing this special evening with us. And after our students have recessed from here in the theater, we're free to meet up with families down in the gymnasium before we move to the cafeteria for our celebration tonight. So, Ms. SG, want to get us out of here? Guys, we're going to follow row by row. We're going to snake out, right?